diagram is often the right tool to use whenever you want to lead your team's thinking from broad generalities to specific details. Now, there are many types of tree diagrams that lead your team's thinking from generalities to details, and you can visit this webpage to learn more about each of these variations. The goal of this video is to teach you how to use any Excel template that uses an Excel hierarchy diagram as one of its foundational components. Now, our online training page will teach you how to work with tree diagrams using Excel 2003 or Excel 2007, but this video is going to assume that you're using Excel 2010 or higher. And frankly, if you're going to do very much with tree diagrams, we highly recommend that you upgrade to Excel 2010 because it's much nicer. So let's get on with it. The first instruction says to double-click anywhere on the diagram and convert it into a SmartArc graphic. Let's do it. First, we click anywhere on the graphic to select it. Then we double-click that thick border edge, which brings up this window that allows us to convert our backward-compatible graphic into a SmartArc graphic. Usually this type your text here window appears to the left of the chart, but my screen is so tiny. Let's delete that, and then let's delete the entire chart and show you the other way that you can do this is to insert SmartArc hierarchy and then choose your preferred type of chart. And there we go. And now the type your text here window is to the left of the chart like it usually is. Like most windows, you can just drag that thing wherever you want, or you can close it to get out of your way. And then when you want it back, you can click this arrow in the middle of the left border of your diagram. So let's go back to our online instructions and scroll down where we learn how to change the size of our workspace. Now, with a Systems to Win template, you hardly ever have to fool around with the print area, so there's only two things you're really thinking about, is how many rows or columns do you have exposed, and what's the size of the drawing space? Let's go do it. First, let's scroll over and notice that there are some hidden rows and columns that make things a lot easier. To just highlight the columns on either side of the hidden ones, right-click Unhide. That's why you don't have to jack with the print area on a Systems to Win template, because you just simply hide and unhide the pre-formatted cells to make your workspace the size you want it to be. And then to change the size of the drawing space itself, you just drag the corners. Simple as that. So now that we have the correct template open, and we've learned how to resize our workspace to be the right size, let's do it. Let's learn how to use a hierarchy diagram. The thing that you'll do the most is edit text, which you should do in the Type Your Text Here window. And notice that whatever you type here will also show up in the chart. To add a shape, just right-click, Add Shape. Let's do it again. Right-click, Add Shape, then choose where you want to add the shape. Pretty easy, yes? Now, to move something around, the last thing you want to do is to actually just pick it up and move it around. Yikes, you're going to have a mess. What you want to do is right-click in the Type Your Text window, and then select one of those four choices to move it around. And yes, move up actually means move left, and move down actually means move right. We didn't write this stuff. We're just trying to teach you how to use it. Talk to Microsoft. If you choose the Promote menu item, that will move it up a level. And if that's not what you meant to do, you can always use the Control-Z key to undo. If you select the Demote menu item, that will move it down beneath the object to the left. To resize a shape, right-click it, select Size and Properties, and change the size so that it can hold longer text. Now, in the SmartArc Tools Design tab, you will always want to choose the Organization Chart Layout. Now, for any selected branch, you can select the Layout drop-down list and choose how you want that branch to be formatted. Any branch might be left hanging, right hanging, standard, or both. Now, also in the Design tab, you can choose between different styles to make your chart more interesting. And on the Format tab, you might choose different colors or outlines, or perhaps even shapes, to make your chart even more interesting and meaningful. Now, because the formats of individual shapes can get messed up, we suggest that's the last thing that you do, or more correctly, the second to the last thing that you do. The very last thing would be to add any additional arrows if you need them to show any complex relationships between shapes. And the reason that we suggest to do that the very last thing is because if you move anything or change anything, those arrows are not connected. So do everything else first and then save the formatting of individual shapes and arrows for the very last thing that you do. Remember, you can always replay anything in this video that you didn't catch the first time, and soon it won't be long before you too are making professional deliverables that turn heads.